remember many a time I came in the bedroom and shut the door. And when they responded, they didn't even know this was happening. Until finally one day they called over. And on the turn of my leg, I put them right here. And when I popped their hiney, I popped my leg at the same time. So all the noise was not coming from them. They just felt a little sting. The noise was coming from my leg. I bruised my leg a million times. I'm in there, and I'm beating my leg, and they're hiding a little bit, and they're crying like they're about to die. And they think they've been killed because they hear that noise. They don't realize that they had a shield on them. And actually, they're not feeling the full force. And you know, a lot of times in our own life, if you trust God and you give it to Him, you may still feel it. But Danny's shielding. You're not getting anything like you could get. Amen? The first time they told me not to spank Bethany because she'd been such an abused child, and not spank her. And she just wouldn't quit. So I had to. I told the social worker, I said, if you want her to come, give it up. I said, we got her. We're going to keep her or adopt her. But if you want to come get me and take me to jail, you want to come get her, whatever. But I can't control her. And she's doing some dangerous stuff that's dangerous for everybody. And so I'm going to spank her. And she said, Mr. Linton, you know better than I do what to do. You do it. I said, thank you, because I'm going to do it anyway. Remember the very first time I turned her over my knee after service. And I did the same thing to her. I actually just spiked my leg and just barely touched her. She screamed bloody murder. Barely cried. DC and Daniel cried. And I cried. We all cried. But when we walked away, everybody was happy with me because I had bruises on my leg. I wonder how many bruises God touched for us. Let me guess. Let's see. At least one, two, three. Wow. That's powerful. Tithing doesn't make you super duper walk over spiritual. All it does is it says, God, I can't handle this on my own. I'm tired of trying on my own. I've got to give it to you. And God says, test it. Try me. He invites us. Just give it a try. See what's going on. Watch the difference. Watch what God will do. Well, everybody, hopefully this has been different. Hopefully it's been an eye-opener. Hopefully this has not been a sandpaper on top of you, but instead it's been a soothing balm. Right now, the altars are open. If you have anything you need from God, anything you want to talk to God about, maybe you've had a shift by listening this morning. You've had a shift. And God has pierced your heart. Whatever. But all that will come to this altar and pray. All that will come to the altar and pray. God's got something special for us. God wants to get involved in your life. God wants to get involved in everything you do. God wants to have His hand in your life. You've got to trust Him. You've got to give it to Him. And the only way to give it to Him is by showing faith. And one of the ways, not all the ways, but one of the ways to show faith, and usually primary, is in that tithe. I found out, after I gave that tithe, I found out that I could live better off of 90% that was blessed than 100% that was cursed. God blessed me in every arena of my life. It was amazing to watch. Was it easy? No. Did I still have to work hard? Yes. Did it still demand that I had to do things? Yes, I had to do my part. But I found out doing my part with the blessings of God was a whole lot easier than me doing my part with no blessings or curses. Wow. I'll tell you why. Everybody stick your hand up. Close your eyes. Repeat after me. Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
For loving me. Thank you, God, bruises.
Thank you for my bruises.
Taking my sin.
Thank you.
I thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
That you see every need in my life.
You see every need in my life.
I ask you right now, Lord, to help me to lay it all down on the altar. Knowing that the altar is a place of sacrifice. Y'all say it. Knowing that the altar is a place of sacrifice. And knowing that the altar is a place of death. God, I need you to intervene in my life. Show me what I must do and how I must do it. And let me live according to your word. In the name of Jesus, I thank you for a better tomorrow than what I had yesterday. When I apply your principles, in the name of Jesus, amen. God's awesome.
All the time.
Obey him. Blessings hard. Y'all stand. This week expected, we're going to talk about stewardship. And of course, stewardship's going to be different than just tithing. Stewardship's going to be your time, your talent, your treasure, all of that involved. And it's going to talk about how to do it in a way that pleases God and honors him and doesn't kill you. I see people do it the wrong way, and not only do not get blessed, they wind up hurting their family. So we're not talking about some kind of crazy mess. We're talking about God's way is a safe way. Amen. Also remember, Sierra's release is going to be operating on Tuesday, right? This is the second surgery on this knee. Okay, they're going to do the surgery to get it right. Yeah, so pray this next
Tuesday. Not this Tuesday. Not this Tuesday on the 13th.
On the 13th, okay.